How do you replace the worn-out battery inside a set of $500 smart glasses? You don't, says Oakley in collaboration with Meta. But after giving it a go, I promise you it's not impossible, just unreasonably difficult. And while these glasses do some pretty cool things, like letting you use AI to check the IP rating of the glasses.
So can I take these surfing with me or not?
No, the Oakley Meta AI glasses aren't designed to resist submersion or extended exposure to water.
IPX4 means you definitely shouldn't go surfing with these on. But don't get distracted by false promises. You're being sold a $500 set of glasses. Can you fix them when the time comes? Let's find out. I'll start by removing the Torx screws on one of the hinges in the hopes that this will be the easiest way to remove one of the arms. I'm going for what I'm assuming is the processor arm first as a practice run for removing the battery arm later. I think this will give me the best chance of demoing a semi-realistic attempt at a battery replacement. As expected, the screws support the hinge, but there's a ribbon cable running from one of the cameras into the arm, and I'll need to disconnect that first. I'll try removing the camera side of the hinge first using some heat. This part looks easier than it actually is. The plastic shell is susceptible to warping well before the glue underneath liquefies, so I'm passing my heat gun over the hinge several times and carefully testing to see if the hinge will come away. After a few attempts, I decided to replace the screws to give me a little leverage and hopefully avoid damaging the delicate ribbon cable inside the hinge when prying. After a few minutes of heating and reheating, I finally start to see results, but at this point I can see that I've warped the plastic enough that it's not quite going to fit back together the same as before. But we're still within serviceable territory, just barely. After removing a metal shield, disconnecting a press connector, and delving even deeper to remove the 12 megapixel camera, it becomes apparent that I opened the wrong side of the hinge if the goal was to get the arm off. That's okay, at least we know that removing the camera module is somewhat possible, though not at all a pleasant experience. So let's turn our attention to that arm we just took off. I'm expecting to find the PCB housing the brains in this arm, along with a speaker and possibly an antenna. Applying heat along the arm and splitting the seam at the narrowest point on the glasses seems to be the best approach for opening these arms up. Once again, I don't see these ever going back together without being at least a little wonky when it sits on your face, but at least the device is still functional. Finally, I can separate the two plastic halves of the arm, which releases the press connector running through the hinge, and then removing the screws lets me separate the arm from the main body. The PCB handling all the processing capabilities on the device is held in place by three Torx screws, and there's a bit of thermal material on the reverse side too. The Oakley Meta HSTN glasses are powered by Qualcomm's AR1 Gen 1 chipset, the same platform we saw on the Ray-Ban Meta smart glasses. The 12 megapixel camera sensor and 32 gigabytes of flash memory are also the same between models. In fact, the hardware is so similar between the two glasses that we're left wondering why the Oakleys can record at a crisp 3K resolution while the Ray-Bans can only do 1440p. Coming back to the arm, I'm going to use my FixHub portable smart soldering iron, which we've got a link to down below, to remove the two solder points on the speaker so I don't have to tear out the entire ribbon cable glued to the plastic shell. After that, it's just a matter of prying out the speaker, which is glued in place. Alright, so now that I've had my practice run, let me try and dismantle the battery side of the arm to simulate a potential battery replacement. At this point, I'm fairly comfortable applying heat to the arm and splitting the two halves of the arm to access the internals. Again, I don't think these arms will go back together quite the same way again, but it is possible to remove the shell without damaging the electronics. And of course, it goes without saying that you can say goodbye to that IPX4 rating if you ever do this. A single screw holds the tiny button board and some circuitry, which I'll remove to prevent any accidental damage. And looking closer at the board itself, you can really see how tiny that button is. Then it's just a matter of gently prying up the lithium battery from the plastic frame. Unlike the Ray-Bans, this tiny 852 milliwatt-hour battery pouch is encased in a metal shell, which makes device entry and battery replacement safer. That's a positive change. The frames themselves house several MEMS microphones, one of which sits underneath the nose guard here, but there's really no reason for us to destroy the rest of these glasses. Suffice to say, if anything happens to the internals inside the frame, it would require a destructive disassembly. Now, speaking of destructive disassembly, let's talk about the battery case. There's a single 18650 cell inside the case connected to some light circuitry, consisting mainly of a battery management system. You can see all those components very clearly here in Lumafield's CT scan. But there's not much else in there, with even Wi-Fi and Bluetooth functionality apparently offloaded to the glasses. We love seeing standard batteries, but unfortunately there's no way to access that battery without destroying the case. All in all, this teardown wasn't AirPods level of terrible, and assuming that you could find the parts, which as far as we know aren't being sold, the repair you're most likely to want to perform on these glasses is a lithium battery replacement. But that repair is neither accessible nor without risk of damage to the frame. Given that these sunglasses are a fashion statement as much as they are a neat bit of tech, that might prove to be a deal breaker for many. So cool glasses, Zuck. Would be a shame if anything happened to them, because they'll be super hard to fix.